स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज राज गजेंद्र पिल्लई, काना किंगडम. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट इंग्लिश ग्रामर. द टॉपिक इज प्रोनाउन. वी विल लर्न अबाउट प्रोनाउंस टुडे. व्हाट आर इट्स काइंड्स एंड विद एग्जांपल्स एंड एक्सरसाइज टू डू इन द लास्ट. बी रेडी विथ योर नोटबुक्स सो दैट यू कैन नोट डाउन ऑल द नेसेसरी इंपॉर्टेंट डेफिनेशंस, एग्जांपल्स एज वेल. So now let's look into the table of contents. What all we are going to learn in the chapter pronoun. So we will be looking at what is pronoun. We'll be learning about what is a pronoun. We'll be looking into what are the kinds of pronoun. Then we will look at the classification, explanation and definition of personal pronoun as well as possessive pronoun. Personal pronoun and possessive pronoun. Examples of pronouns, both personal, possessive. Then we will be doing an exercise in the last. So be ready, write it down. Now let's look into what is pronoun. Pronoun is a word that replaces noun. What is a noun? Noun is a naming bird. Noun is the name of people, place, animal, thing, birds, ideas, ideologies, right? So now when you see, a pronoun is used. Why? Pronoun is used to replace a word, noun, because the same word or the same name should not be repeated over again and again. So we replace generally a noun with a pronoun, right? So that it doesn't get repeated again and again. Now, for the better understanding, we'll see more examples about how the replacement is done of noun into a pronoun. Yeah. So please write this down. What is pronoun? Pronoun is a word that replaces noun. Write it down. So we will understand it briefly with examples. So now let's see what is a noun, what is a pronoun. Noun is what? Noun is a naming word of people, place, animal, thing, which is replaced by a pronoun. Yeah. Now let's see what are the kinds of pronouns. Let's see what are the kinds of pronouns. The kinds of pronouns are personal and possessive. What are the kinds of pronoun? There are two types of pronoun. There are two kinds of pronoun, which we say personal and possessive. Yeah. Pronouns are what? Pronoun is a word that replaces noun. Now there are two kinds of pronouns. It's personal and possessive. When we talk about personal and possessive, for better understanding, we will see the examples. I'll explain it there. So for your understanding, for your writing, please write what is a noun, what is a pronoun. Pronoun is the word that replaces noun, and there are two kinds of pronoun where we say it's personal and possessive. For now, it's only two to learn, personal and possessive. More as you go into the higher standards, so there are more to be learned about the pronouns. So this pronoun we are learning about is personal pronoun and possessive pronoun. Write it down. Now let's look on the personal pronouns. So there are two kinds of pronouns. One is personal and one is possessive, right? So now let's see what are personal pronouns. Personal pronouns take the place of proper and common nouns. What is proper noun and common noun? Proper noun are used for the specific thing, a particular thing. What are common nouns? Common nouns are used for somebody or someone of a category or sect. It's like for a category or sect, for somebody, someone. it's addressed common names, like common names, like for students, for children, for students, for lawyers. So it's common name addressed. It's commonly addressed. Proper is proper, specific city, specific place, specific animal. It's addressed with a proper perfection. It's always addressed like proper Delhi, or properly Rajesh, properly dog. We commonly call as dogs, but commonly as a dog with a name like Bruzo. It's particularly addressed to the specific name of people, place, thing. See, proper, right? Proper and common. Now we understand what are the personal pronouns. Personal pronouns take place of the specific names, like specific names or common nouns in general, when we commonly use, like for students we call, for lawyers, for teachers. These are all the common nouns used. So personal pronouns takes the place of proper and common nouns. Please write it down. So now let's look on the position of pronoun. Yes, this is before the action word or after the action word. What are action words? Action words are the verbs, right? So now let's see the person talking. Is the person talking? I. After the action word, it becomes what? It becomes me, right? The person talking, I. After the action word, what it becomes? It becomes me. When you address you, the one being talked to, when I am talking to somebody, it's you. The one being talked to, when I am talking to you, the one being talked to, that's you. After the action word, it becomes you. She is what? She is an address to female. After the action word, it becomes her. She, her. Before the action word, it's he. For male, we address it as he. After the action word, it becomes what? He becomes him. He had brought this. Tell him to get this back. Tell him to take it back. It. What is it? Animal or non-living thing is addressed with the pronoun it. After the action word also, it becomes it. It is always stays as it. If you are many people, including a big group sitting along with me, including the one who is talking, I am talking about this place, about things, about some topic. We, many, we are talking about, when we are sitting and addressing something, we will talk as we. We are all sitting in the class. We all will go. What does this becomes after the action word? After this action word, it becomes us. After the action word, it becomes us. When we address before the action word, it's we. Many, including the one who is talking. After the action word, it becomes let us do it. We will do that. Let us do that. We'll say, we will do that. Let us do this. When we talk about many, not including the one talking, if I am not there, if I am seeing a group sitting there, what? How I will address as a pronoun? As a pronoun, I will use what word? They. They are all sitting in one class. Let them come out. After the action word, it becomes what? Let them come out. So this is what is the use of a pronoun. Before the action word, the person talking is I. A single person talking, I. It after the action word, it becomes what? It becomes me. It becomes me. I becomes me. The one I am talking to, means if you are talking to me, I become you for you, and if I talk to you, you become you. I, the one being talked to is you, I, you. After the action word also it becomes what? It becomes, it stays you. She is addressed for what? She is addressed for a female. After the action word, her. She has got one book. Let her take that book. After the action word, he is what? Male. He will come. Tell him to come. After the action word, tell him to come. It is addressed to the same male. When you talk about action word, animal or non-living thing, we address as what? As a pronoun, it. After the action word also, it stays the same, it, like you. It stays the same, even after the action word. You is always you. And here, it is always it. Where is the word? Where is this pronoun used, it? For animal and non-living thing. If there are many people, and the person who is talking is included in that group, he address as what? Address as we, W-E-V, as a pronoun. And after the action word, it becomes us. Let us do that. We will do that. Let us do that. They is addressed when? When I am not present here and I am talking about many people, not including one talking. When I'm talking about many people, they, before the action word, they may go. Tell them to go. After the action word, it becomes them. Right? So where are the pronouns, the position of pronouns you have seen? For the personal talking, it's I, which becomes me. The one being talked to, if I'm talking to you, it's you. Then it is you, and after the action word also it's you. She is addressed for female. She becomes her after the action word. He is addressed for male. It becomes him. It, addressed for animal or non-living thing, it stays it as it is. We, many people, including one who is talking, that's me, including all the people when I am addressing something, it's we. After the action word, it becomes what? Us. They, there are many, not including the one who is talking, they. If I am not there in the room and something is happening in the classroom, then I will address as they. They are all sitting in one class. Look at them, what they are doing. After that, after the action word, it becomes, I have told them. I have told them. We'll talk about them. After the action word, it becomes them. So now, you know the positions of pronoun. Let's go ahead to look on more examples for understanding the position of pronoun, about pronouns. So now, let's look at the examples. More examples to understand better about pronouns. Look at the example, first one on the top. He went to the playground during recess. In the blue it's highlighted he. What is this he? He is the pronoun. What is he? He is the pronoun. Where is the he used? He is used for a male, as we have seen in the example, as we have seen in the position of pronoun. Where is he used? He is used for the male, right? He went to the playground during recess. So now the word he is what? He is addressed for a male. Now let's look at the second example. She called on Mary. When you talk about she called on Mary, We have seen the position of pronoun where it showed she was used for a female. So now in the second position here, she is used for a female, right? She called on Mary. She called on Mary. So now look at the third example. Miss Santos called on him. Where is this him used? This him is used after action word for a male. Where is it used? We had seen in the position of pronoun where was this word him used? Him was used for the male after the action word. First it was he, after the action word it became what? It became him, right? So Miss Santos called on him. This is again addressed for a male after the action word. Miss Santos called on her. What is this her? This her is used for a female. Before action word it was she. After the action word it became what? It became her. Same as he became him, she became her. Right? For these examples, so come to know how the pronouns are used. He for male. After the action word, Santos called on him. This is the third one which I am reading. It is again for male. She is what? She called on Mary. She is used for female before action word. After the action word, Miss Santos called on her. Her is used after the action word. Both are used for female, she and her. He and him is used for male. Understood? Yes. So this is how the position of pronouns work. You need to memorize it and know where it is used. I become we. Right? She becomes her after the action word. Before action word, after action word. How are the pronouns placed? So, I told you to write it down. Please write it down, sir. More examples to look. So now, let's see the examples of we and they. What is we? We is the pronoun used for many, including the one who is talking, who is in the subject, who is before the action word. Right? We is what? We is a pronoun which is used including the one who is talking. And what is the they? They are used for many but not including the one who is talking. They is what? They is a pronoun which is used when he is not being included in that. I am not in this room. When I am in this room, I talk about we. When I am not in this room and talking about that particular room of many people, what I talk is they. I will address as they. The pronoun here is they. Both are pronouns. Both are used before action word. We are practicing the dance. When we talk about we are practicing in the dance, it's like we means I am also present there. The one who is talking is included. They are practicing the dance means the one talking is not included. He is telling something about the dance practicing which is going on. Done by whom? Done by they. He is addressing as they. There are many people who are dancing. They are practicing the dance. The pronoun used here is they. The one who is talking is not included. So we and they are both pronouns used before the action word. Now let's do a small exercise about the things learned. The next clip ahead is we will look into a small exercise now. Now let's look into the exercise. What we have learned, the pronouns which we have learned now. Let's identify. Write the pronouns in the used sentence. We have to find out. So look at the sentences in the last there is a digit given in the bracket 1 1 2 1 2. There is one pronoun here, so we need to find out one pronoun. We have to search one pronoun in the sentence. He likes to play with kids. He likes to play. What is the word he? He is a pronoun used for whom? It's used for a male, right? So now he is the pronoun used in the sentence. So there is one pronoun in this sentence, that is he. He is used for male. We should listen to one another. Here also it's one pronoun, it says. Now what is the pronoun here? We should listen to one another. We is what? We is the pronoun used for many, including the one who is talking. Including the one who is talking before the action word. Right? We is what? We is a pronoun. Where it is used? It's used to address many people, including the person who is talking. We. So here we have identified we. I heard them singing downstairs. I heard them singing downstairs. I is the person who is talking. I is an pronoun. I heard them. Them is what? Them is a pronoun used after the action word. What is them? Them is the pronoun which is used after the action word. So I and them are the two pronouns used in the sentence. I heard them singing downstairs. I and them are what? They are the pronouns. They surely know the answer. Here it says it's they have one pronoun. They. T-H-E-Y. They. They is what? They is the pronoun that doesn't include the person who is talking. We are addressing about they. Means I am not present, I am not included here. So we are talking about they. Right? So they is the pronoun used in the sentence. Now in the last one, the fifth one, said, I told her to be quiet. I, talking about I. Right? I is a pronoun. Told her. What is her? Where is the word? The pronoun word her. Her is addressed to a female after the action word. After the action word of a female, we call her her. So here there is two pronouns. I told her. Her is the second pronoun used in the sentence here. So now we have identified he likes to play with kids, he. We should listen to one another, we. I heard them singing downstairs, I and them. They surely know the answer, they. I told her to be quiet, I and her. These are the two pronouns used. Please write it down. So now we have done five questions. The five sentences where it said 1 and 2, we have identified how many pronouns. Now here, the exercise is choose the correct pronoun for each sentence. I asked to help my sister. I asked to help my sister. Options given are two pronouns here, they and them. Which is the proper one you need to use here? Choose the proper one, they and them. I asked to help my sister. So here it would be I asked them, T-H-E-M, them, to help my sister. I asked them to help my sister. So them is the correct answer here. So we have choose them. She, her, called I, me yesterday. Now she, her is used for females. I and me is for me. Right? So now let's see what is the correct answer here. She called me yesterday. She called me yesterday. She is what? She is used for a female, right? Called me. Me is what? Me is a pronoun used after action verb. Yesterday. She called me yesterday. This is the correct answer. Please write it down. They blamed us for losing the game. They blamed us. U-S, us. Us is what? Us is the action word which is used. Us is the word. Us is the pronoun which is used after the action word. Right? They blamed us for losing the game. So now here the proper correct pronoun is us. U-S, us. Please write it down. I asked them to help my sister. She called me yesterday. They blamed us for losing the game. Please write it down. So now, after looking into personal pronouns, let's go ahead with possessive pronouns. What are possessive pronouns? Possessive pronouns shows ownership. They take the place of nouns belonging to someone or someone else. What is possessive? Possessive means something which shows the ownership. Possessive pronouns shows the ownership. They take place of a noun belonging to someone or something else. Right? Possessive. Possessive means showing the ownership. This is mine. Hers. Right? It is showing something. That somebody is the owner of this. Possessive. Possessive pronoun shows ownership. They take place of nouns belonging to someone or something else. Right? So now here the example is, just for your understanding, the eraser is hers. When we talk about hers, it is particularly addressed to hers. Hers is what? She, hers. It's talking about a female. It's talking about a female character. Where she says, this eraser is hers. Particularly about one such female. That it belongs to hers. Right? What is hers? Hers is used where? Hers is used after the action word. So, in the possessive pronoun, it shows about the ownership. Right? Please write it down. Possessive pronouns shows the ownership. They take place of the noun belonging to someone or something else. Please write this definition so that you memorize it and see more examples to understand it better. Please write it down. Look at the example of possessive pronouns. This classroom is ours. Note the one who is talking is included. I am sitting here and I am telling that this classroom is ours. When we are talking about ours, the one who is talking, me, is included here. I am talking about this classroom is ours. It is showing the ownership. Possessive pronoun is ours. Right? The possessive pronoun is ours. When the one is including who is talking about this class, I am sitting here and I am talking. This classroom is ours. When we talk about ours, the one who is talking is included. So the possessive pronoun here is ours. Write it down. Now here, look at the example. Possessive pronouns. This classroom is theirs. When we're talking about theirs, P-H-E-I-R-S, this classroom is theirs. Means the one who I am talking, that this classroom is theirs. That means the one talking is not included. I am not here. I am talking about the classroom which is theirs. This classroom is theirs. means the one who is talking is not included. The possessive pronoun word used here is theirs, theirs. The first one was ours, this one is theirs. When I am not present here, I am not included here, I am just telling that this classroom is theirs. Theirs, the possessive pronoun here is theirs, theirs. Write it down. Now let's spot the pronoun. Let's spot. Spot means let's find out the pronouns. She is pretty. When we talk about she is pretty, where, what is this? She. She is what? She is personal pronoun. What is she? She is a pronoun which is personal. She is pretty. Where is the word she used? She is used for a female. This is personal pronoun. Write it down. Now spot the pronoun. So one more example. I gave Cheryl's number to them. Here there are hint that there are two pronouns here. First one is I. What is I? Which type of pronoun it is? I means personal pronoun. I gave Cheryl's number to them. Them is again what? Them is a personal pronoun. Them. I, personal. Them is also personal pronoun. Right? So now, here we have identified two pronouns. I and them. Both are personal pronouns. Now, please write it down. Now here, spot the pronoun. The pencil is hers. Here the hint is, there is one pronoun used in the sentence. The pencil is hers. When we talk about hers, which type of pronoun is this? This is possessive pronoun, where it is telling the pencil is hers, the ownership, the pen, the pencil's owner is talking about her. Hers, when you talk about hers, this is showing the possessive thing about the pencil. The pencil is hers. Hers is what? Possessive pronoun. Please write it down. Now we are spotting the pronoun and identifying whether it's personal or possessive. So we have seen the personal one in the last. Now we are seeing the possessive. Write it down. So now, spot the pronoun. Here, she told me it was mine. She told me it was mine. So now here we got an hint of four pronouns here. Four pronouns used in one sentence. She told me it was mine. Now you have to identify personal and possessive pronoun used. She, S-H-E, she. She is what? Personal, she, female. Me, again personal, after the action word. It, again personal. Was mine. Mine is what? Mine is again showing something about the ownership. Mine, ours, mine. When you talk about mine, mine is what? Mine is not personal, it is possessive now. It's a possessive pronoun. Right? She is what? Is personal. Me is what? Personal. After the action word. It is what? It's used for animals and non-living things. It was mine. When you talk about mine, means it shows some ownership. What? The ownership is what? It's possessiveness. Possessive is what? Possessive pronoun. When you talk about personal and possessive, mine, ours, these are all possessive pronouns. So we have identified four pronouns here. She, personal. Me, personal. It, personal. It for non-living thing. Mine is possessive pronoun. So now, write it down. So now, one more. Spot the pronoun. A little dog had gotten separated from its owner. Here the hint is one pronoun you need to spot. A little dog had gotten separated from its owner. Right? From its owner. When we talk about a little dog had gotten separated from its owner. So now what is the pronoun here? A little dog had gotten separated from its. I-T-S, its. Its is the pronoun user. But what it? Its. It, we saw, it's non-living thing. Its owner, its owner. When it's talking about its owner, its means what? Its. It shows the possessiveness. Right? So now, it said what? It's not showing personal. It's not, it's is the possessive thing which is shown. Its owner, when it's talking about its owner. It says what? It's a possessive pronoun. Here we have got an hint of one pronoun. That one pronoun is its. That's what? It's an possessive pronoun. A little dog had gotten separated from its owner. So now it says what? It's a possessive pronoun. Please write it down. Spot the pronoun. One more example here for you. Here it hints that there is three pronoun in a sentence. This pencil is not mine, it is hers. This pencil is not mine, it is hers. When you talk about this, the pencil is not mine. We'll talk about the pencil is not mine. When you talk about mine, mine is what? It shows about the possessiveness, the ownership, mine. So mine is what? Is a possessive pronoun. It is hers. It. What is it? It is a personal pronoun used before action. Before action. For non-living thing and animal, it's used it. It is what? It is personal pronoun. It is personal pronoun. Hers. Hers is used for she, female. Before action word, after action word, it becomes her. We talk about hers. Hers shows what? It shows the possessiveness, the ownership. Right? So here, hers will be what? It's a possessive pronoun. So here, there are two possessive pronouns and one personal pronoun. Mine, showing the ownership. This pencil is not mine. Possessive. It is personal. Is hers. When it is talk about hers, means it is showing again the ownership. Possessiveness. So now, hers is what? Hers is possessive pronoun. So please write it down. So now, let's see the exercise. Choose the correct pronoun. When we talk about choose the correct pronoun, there are sentences given where we have to identify and circle it. Right? Anna likes to eat cake. She eat he. Can even eat the whole cake all by herself. So here, when we talk about Anna likes to eat cake, full stop, she eat he. Can even eat the whole cake all by herself. So now here, what is the correct pronoun? The correct pronoun is she. In the place of Anna, we would address it. We will replace it with the name she. She is a pronoun used for Anna. Anna likes to eat cake. She is used because Anna is a female character. So female is she. Anna, she. She can even eat the whole cake all by herself. The book looks old. Full stop. She, it, they is covered with dust. And some of hers, its, theirs pages are ripped. Here it says the books look old. It is covered with dust. So it is not she or they. It is covered. When it's a non-living thing. The book is a non-living thing. For non-living thing, it is used for animals and non-living things. It is covered with dust and some of its pages are ripped. Means it's all ripped. It's out of the thread which is binded. It's out of the thread. So here the proper pronouns used are it and its. It is used where? I told you. It is used for non-living thing and animals. The book looks old. It is covered with dust and some of its pages are ripped. Let's go to the third sentence. I and my friends like to have fun. I and my friends like to have fun. Full stop. We always hang out together. I and my friends like to have fun. We always hang together. When we talk about we, means I am also included in that. This is a personal pronoun. We always hangs out together. I saw Lisa approach her friends. I saw Lisa approach her friends. She asked us them about the project in English. Us and them are the options here. I saw Lisa approach her friends. She asked them about the project in the English. She asked them. She asked them. Them is what? Them is a personal pronoun. Right? So, they asked them about the project in English. So, them is the correct pronoun used here. So, we have identified personal, we have identified possessive, we have learnt about both personal and possessive pronoun. What are pronouns? We know about it. So now, let's memorize it one more time. Write it down in the book. Please go through. So now you have learned about pronouns and the examples you have seen of personal and possessive. Happy learning about the pronouns. Thank you.